potter's journal of what's going on in my old truck body studio today. I'm getting ready to volunteer with my historic society, and I want to do some cobalt blue pieces with the slips on them. And I knew I had a few old pieces abandoned in here. I believe that's called a sunflower pattern, and a rose, which I don't think is a PA, Pennsylvania piece. The tulip and the heart is what I did the most of. There it is with a soap pump. Okay, and if you didn't see the old truck body kiln shed clip, okay, here's the old kiln, and there was another one on the other side. I'd like to install a wheel over there, but I'm getting some, I need to mix up some slip, and this is that mold-made ceramic stuff that I'm going to bust up to use the white and add a percentage of cobalt to it. But I knew there were some old pieces that were either broken and abandoned here, or maybe abandoned here and then broken. I can see this one is. But I just wanted to see what I'd done in the past. And see, some kind of floral pattern, I guess. I do recognize this as being a traditional pattern. What else is here? Okay, these must have been underneath there, not and didn't get filled with water and break. 93, so this has been a while. Okay, oh wow, I've just recently sketched this one in my sketchbook from some a collector's book of historic pots, and that is a two floral, some leaves, and a basket, and I was planning on doing that one again. And, another one, not broken, must have been under there far enough. Okay, and this is what I did for my production line years ago, the tulip. And then I know this one, oh wow, look at that. I think I had a Christmas tree in it. I took the Christmas tree out and in the middle of winter and froze the bottom out of it, but I knew it was worth holding on to just for the slip work. That, okay, we'll see if I can do it that good today. It might, yeah, wow, look at that. Okay, this is probably about the same time period as 90, 93, 95 when I was doing this is a production line. Okay, well, that's enough for the old truck body studio. Let's get into the one I'm using now and see what we can get done in the pottery studio today. Oh wow, there's a tree down on this. I don't want to lose this studio space. I better get the chainsaw out and clean that up. Okay, I'm going to be working on the pot for the Southside Historic Village, and I'm just going to do my standard heart, tulip, I could have switched out to a smaller brush for that. Okay, I couldn't do this at all yesterday, so maybe the practice part is what helped. Let's see, we'll try. Okay, wrong size brush for this scale. And then, so we can see the way they loop around the pot, I just paint the other ones off to the side. Okay. So I'll practice a couple times on the garlic jars before moving up to larger piece. See, I think, yeah, we'll keep that banding up at the top. Okay, and the back is usually the side that I have my stamp on. So I'll do just the heart on the back. Tulips. Hearts on the front. Okay, and I missed that part on the first one. Okay, and this is the piece, yeah, I stamped Southside Historic Village when I was volunteering there last summer. I made it during the week that were open non-stop to the public during a fair. I will enter it in the fair for the village and hopefully win the village prize, and then donate it to a fundraiser auction this December. And, I did this banding while I was throwing it on the wheel, and let's see, how do I do this? Since, yes, those pieces I pulled out of that old, truck body kiln shed were old pieces, and this has been a while. Okay, yeah, some watery slip to get the cobalt blue down in the grooves where I stamped this, and then a sponge to wipe it off the high parts. And let's see if I have any water here. Okay, I think that worked. And after doing it with a wet sponge, I will do it with a dry sponge. Okay, so we got the cobalt down in the grooves to show off the writing. And the date, that number one seems to, so a little scrub on the pad. Okay, now okay, get the journal out. So that heart is relatively in the middle. It's not a perfect one. It's not supposed to be. And the tulips. Let's see, we've got one coming up here. And we've got another one going off to the side. Now, the question is there really room on the pot? Just because there's room in the sketchbook for them. Okay, and let's see, the fine brush. Okay, so I'll bring this one more in and this other one more down. Side ones. think I'm out of practice compared to these old pieces that were pulled out, but yeah. And on the back, let's see. What do we do on the back? Just a real simple heart. Okay, and maybe we'll just go over the handle once or twice. Okay, so that is it. We'll get this glazed in the kiln and hopefully get the prize for it, and send it off to the auction for the fundraiser for the Southside Historic Village. I will be there volunteering in the next group of videos. However, in the next video, we'll do that cobalt stuff on the pie plates and the bowls. Okay, so back and see how that all goes.